Hey, what is going on, everybody? It's Pete Holman. Welcome to the Todd Durkin Impact Summit. If you don't know me, I'm a physical therapist, certified strength and conditioning specialist, former US National TaeKwon-Do champion and team captain and fitness product inventor. I created something called the Functional Training Rack, the TRX Rip Trainer, the plate-loaded hip thrust machine called the Nautilus Glute Drive, and my latest product invention is called the Escape Barrow, which is a combination loaded carry and push sled machine. I'm very excited about that. That should launch in 2022, first quarter. I first met Todd Durkin at the TRX headquarters in 2011, and he was doing a tour of the headquarters with his mastermind group, and I was just launching the Rip Trainer at the time, and he saw me in the training center, and he said, "Hey, who's that dude?" He's with Randy Hetrick, right? The CEO of Fitness Anywhere. He said, "Who's that dude and what is that product?" And Randy said, "Oh, let me come introduce you." So we first met. Next thing you know, there's a film crew around and Todd and I are doing a film session on the Rip Trainer. He'd never even seen it before. And his energy, his enthusiasm, his passion, the light he brought into the room was infectious. And we've been friends ever since. Today, I'm not going to talk about what my usual topics are: clinical physical therapy, strength and conditioning, fitness entrepreneurship. This session is straight from the heart. In fact, this is a session that wasn't even gonna really happen until Todd Durkin talked me into it. The last 2 years have been devastating for me. It started out in 2018, November 2018, I had a total knee replacement. I finally start feeling better from that and COVID strikes. And up in the mountains in a ski resort in Aspen, the mountains shut down in the middle of our tourist season. And when the mountains shut down in ski season, guess what happens to the population? They just head back to New York or Chicago or LA or Florida or wherever they're from, and everything dries up. Now, granted, the first couple weeks, I was like in my couch, I'm sleeping in, I'm working out. I'm like, this is great. But after 2 or 3 weeks, you've got no money coming in. And things start to dry up. And I thought, okay, don't worry, Holman. You've got two products that are going to be launching here soon. Well, the next thing you know, IRSA, which is the big trade show that happens every March, that got canceled because of COVID. All my speaking gigs that year got canceled because of COVID. Now, all of a sudden, I've got a six-figure turn in income. I've got no physical therapy clients. I've got no personal training clients. And my two products that were supposed to launch are kaput. On top of that, I've been going through a very challenging and difficult dissolution of a 20 plus year marriage. Now, this is something I'm sharing that's very vulnerable at this point in my life. This is something that's absolutely has to happen, and it's gonna be the best result for everybody. But while you're going through it, it is absolutely devastating. It's devastating to me, it's devastating to my wife, it's challenging and devastating to my daughter, my 15-year-old daughter, to the point where, I've been waking up lately, shrugging my shoulders and thinking, what's this even all about? Like, I literally want to put on a rucksack and just head back into the mountains and never be seen again. That's how kind of downtrodden I've been. And Todd Durkin came to me with this request, hey, can you present at the Todd Durkin Impact Summit? And I couldn't even talk to him in person. I just had to email him back. I'm like, buddy, I'm going through some stuff. I just can't do it this year. I'm so sorry. And a couple days went by, and then I get a call. And it's Todd. And of course, Todd comes in with all this, you know, magnetic energy and universal gusto. And he kind of talks me off the ledge and says, hey, maybe this is the perfect time for you to present something. And I'm still kind of like, oh, on the ledge. And then I saw an Instagram post. And I want to share that post with you right now.
The most important conversation you will ever have in your fucking life is the one you have with yourself. You wake up with it. You walk around with it. You go to bed with it. Eventually, you're going to act on it, whether you're good or bad. So many people die, live 100 years, never fucking know who they are. Never know who they are. You have to look in that mirror and know this. There's so much more in here, man.
Now, folks, I apologize for the foul language, and I don't really agree with that. But if you don't know who David Coggins is, he's an ex-Navy SEAL. He's an ultra-endurance athlete, and he's now a motivational speaker. And regardless of the language, the content he delivers is outstanding. And he doesn't pull any punches. Think about what he said. You wake up with it. You walk around with it. You go to bed with it. At some point, you're going to act on it, right? The thoughts in our head control our actions. They develop our character. And if the thoughts in your head are constantly downtrodden, like I want to put on a rucksack and go into the back of the mountains, that's not going to get us to where we need to be. Today's a special day, folks. Today's my birthday. I turned 52 today, you know? Not bad for a 52-year-old. And it's taken me 52 years to figure out what it's all about. You know, you ever wonder, what is it all about? What is the meaning of life? Well, guess what? It's your lucky day, because I'm going to tell you what the meaning of life is. Are you ready? Sit down, brace yourself. The meaning of life is self-actualization. Think about it. You can't do anything. You can't help others. You can't inspire others. You can't elevate others unless you yourself are elevated. Until you learn and grow and evolve as a human being, you're of no good to anybody. And really, at the end of the day, we're only as good as the people that we can elevate around us. So the meaning of life is self-actualization. Now, how do you get there? So believe it or not, in undergraduate school, I was a psychology major. I wasn't into health and fitness. I was into psychology. Both my parents were psychologists, and I wanted to follow in their footsteps. And I was studying a guy by the name of Abraham Maslow. Now, Maslow was a very famous psychologist, and in 1943, he came up with something called the hierarchy of human needs. And it basically was a progressive level towards self-actualization. The first level was basic physiological needs, right? You need food and water, you gotta survive. The second level was safety needs, security, protection from the outside world. Then he got up into love and belongingness, feeling part of a community, feeling supported, social support. And then the fourth level was self-esteem, finally developing your ego and who you are and what you're all about. And then finally, self-actualization at the top of the pyramid. Now he said most people never get to the self-actualization position on the pyramid, but that is the goal. So with a little bit of liberty and hopefully a blessing from the past Abraham Maslow, please don't be mad at me, I want to tweak this pyramid for fit pros. So this is the Holman hierarchy of fit pro needs. And we're going to start with need number one, and that is purify or purification. Now, what does that mean, folks? When I was young, I was a nightmare. My mom, do you guys ever see the Looney Tunes Tasmanian Devil? If you haven't, Google Looney Tunes Tasmanian Devil, and you'll see this kind of character that spins out of control and always wreaking havoc and death and destruction amongst his or in his wake. And I was the Tasmanian Devil. There was not a day that went by, especially in the summer, that I didn't come home with a wound, an open gash, bleeding knees, a laceration in my head. And what did my mom do every single time? She did the same thing. She'd sit me down. She'd get out the hydrogen peroxide, right, and the cotton swabs and the Q-tips, and she'd start to purify the wound, cleanse the wound. She'd pick out the sod and the gravel and the dirt and the debris and make sure there was no bacteria in there before putting on Neosporin and gauze and bandages and Band-Aids, right? You got to purify before you can elevate yourself up. Now, what does that mean for fit pros? Well, it means your diet, right? Purify your diet. One thing I'm doing right now is I'm eating a salad a day, a big gnarly kale, spinach, greens, avocado, bell pepper, a big gnarly salad every day. And it's not only helping me on the inside, but the psychology of going through that discipline of, it's been 6 weeks, by the way, I've not missed a salad every lunch for 6 weeks. The discipline of focusing on my health and my nutrition transfers into other aspects of my life. By the way, I've also thrown out all the junk, the candy, the ice cream, the chips, the crackers, all the stuff that's just not going to get me to where I need to go from the inside out, I've thrown away. What about alcohol? Now, I'm not talking about having a half glass of wine at dinner. I'm talking about, you know, if you're drinking 2, 3, 4 drinks a night consistently, purify, right? You can't actualize your God-given human potential if you're all liquored up all the time. Okay, I'm just saying, purify. What about exercise, right? How frequently are you exercising? I tell this to people every single time I talk about physical activity. You go into a workout, you don't want to do it. You feel like crap. My joints hurt. This is me talking. Every joint in my body hurts. I'm tired. It's been the end of a long work day. I don't want to do this. This sucks. And then how do you feel at the end of the workout? Man, you are walking on water. You're like, I did it. I feel good. I'm pumped up. I took care of myself today. So purify with your physical activity. And the final step of purification is relationships, right? And this is a tough one. This is one that takes a lot of consideration, but if you have toxic relationships, you've heard this before, but maybe this time you'll actually act on it. If you have toxic relationships that are not helping you elevate along the Holman hierarchy of fitness pro self-actualization, you've got to purify. Now, I'm not saying you just cut them out of your life completely, but maybe you take a break. You see how you feel without them in your life. So this could be coworkers. This could be interpersonal relationships. This could be loved ones. But you gotta, if you want to elevate yourself and hit your human potential, you've got to be conscious of those people that you're surrounding yourself with, and are they helping you up this ladder or up this pyramid?
Wasn't really feeling it this morning. Was doing one more stretch. Looking for the right music to play for a little bit longer, setting up the workout a little bit more, just procrastinating and hesitating. And then finally realized what I was doing and pressed start on my stopwatch. So that's what you do. You get bogged down a little bit, you're hesitating, press start on the stopwatch and go.
I know I'm a little heavy on the Navy SEALs today, sorry about that. But what a great quote, right? For gosh sakes, folks, hit start on the stopwatch. Start the process. Start with purification. And then once you're ready, we'll go to the next phase, which is qualify, right? Very important stage of this process, qualify. Who are you? What are you about? What do you stand for? What's your mission statement? You know, Todd Durkin in the mastermind group, every year he has us do this practice. We take a notebook and we go out by the track, the turf, the field, the running stream, the lake, the beach, wherever we're at. But it's always out in nature. And he has us write down what our mission statement is, right? Who we are, what we want on our tombstone at the end of our lives, right? These are huge monumental things. And you think it's easy. You go down and you sit down on the rock by the river and it's running and you kind of get distracted and you're looking around and you're like, kind of, who am I? What am I about? But you gotta qualify, right? Joseph Campbell, the famous Harvard educator and author, once said, follow your bliss. Simple statement, one of the most profound statements you'll ever hear. Follow your bliss. What are you passionate about? And you know when somebody's following their bliss. When you see Steve Jobs present an Apple keynote, you know he is in the element. I mean, that there's no place he'd rather be. When you see Megan Rapinoe kick a game-winning soccer goal, right, or penalty kick, and slide knee first, right, into the crowd, you know that is her life's passion. She's following her bliss. Or how about Bruno Mars, you know, getting after it on stage. Man, these folks are following their bliss. They're in their light. They're in their element, and you got to do the same thing. So here's your homework. It's not going to be easy, but do what we do in the Todd Durkin group. Get a notebook. Go somewhere. I really recommend in nature. You know, not in your den when your kids are running around or whatever. Go outside somewhere, by a lake, a track, a turf, a field, somewhere in nature, and get in your element and write down your mission statement. Right? Who are you? What do you want to do? I'll share mine with you. I want to help elevate those around me. That is my mission. Simple as that. Right? I want to help other people actualize their God-given human potential. Now, I do it through physical therapy. I do it through strength and conditioning one-on-one. I do it through product development, design, iteration, distribution. And those are my vehicles to deliver and help elevate. What are yours? How are you going to do it? Are you going to run your gym better? Are you going to open up a gym? Are you going to start digital online content? Are you going to start a whole new business? Are you going to write a book like Greg Justice? Hopefully you'll listen to the Greg Justice keynote on how to become an author. How are you going to elevate yourself and how are you going to qualify yourself so that you can get to the next level. By the way, it is very important that you do this step and you actually write it down. Hall of Fame running back Emmitt Smith from the Dallas Cowboys once said, "A dream is just a dream until you write it down. Then it becomes reality," right? And here's something even more profound. Write down your dream, your mission statement, and then show it to somebody. Maybe somebody safe, your loved one, your kids, your friends, your coworkers. Show it to somebody. Then there's pressures on. Then you got to start ascending up the pyramid. Okay, moving right along on the ascension up the Holman hierarchy of fit pro needs. Third stage. Calcify. Calcification. When I was in graduate school, I was on the US National Taekwondo team. And to be honest, there was some political stuff going on in Taekwondo at the time. And I was craving some heavier contact, some full contact stuff that wasn't so much point fighting. And one of my students that was in my same grade went to Enshin Karate. And Enshin Karate was the home of Shihan Joko Nanomiya, which I later learned was the winner of the 1976 All Japan tournament, the Sabaki tournament. And he'd actually brought Sabaki to Denver, Colorado. And so he had this Enshin Karate dojo where he had Japanese dudes living there full time, training every day. And one of his students' name was Suzuki. And Suzuki would be seen, he had, you know, not a book, but a plywood kind of chunk of wood that he would walk around all day long like this, just hitting that wood. And he would switch hands, left hand, right hand, 10, 20 hits, and then he'd switch all day long. You looked at his knuckle. There weren't even knuckles, right, anymore. It was just one massive, it looked like an anvil, you know? It was all calcified and gnarly. And why did he do this? We did it for a couple of reasons. Number one is that if you break your hand in the Sabaki tournament because you have no gloves on, you're out of the tournament. Secondarily, when you have a stronger, more resilient fist, it hits with more effective mass and you have a better striking tool. So he's calcifying his tools, folks. Malcolm Gladwell, in his book Outliers, talks about the 10,000-hour rule, how it takes 10,000 hours for somebody to become competent in sports or their craft. When I was growing up, my favorite superhero was not Batman or Superman or Spider-Man. It was Michael Jordan. Yeah, he was a superhero to me. And Michael Jordan was famous for, after every practice, didn't matter how he was feeling, if he was injured or not, after every practice, he'd go to the free throw line, right? And shoot, he'd try to hit 100 free throws straight. Now, rarely did he make 100 in a row. He'd make 50, 60, 70 before he missed one, but he would shoot 100 free throws after every practice. He was calcifying his tools. So here's my ask of you. The next time you're preparing a pitch deck for your investors, a presentation to your staff, maybe you're preparing for a job interview or a podcast interview, calcify your tools. Practice that chisel 1,000 times until you don't even need a pitch deck. You've got it memorized, right? The more you can do this in multiple aspects of your life, the more you're going to be able to ascend up the Holman hierarchy of fit pro needs. And by the way, here's a great clip of one of my favorite moments in sports history when Michael Jordan proves he is the best basketball player of all time.
Well, he closed his eyes. Emory did it in preseason against the Nuggets. 106-100, 3.5 seconds ago. Let's watch Jordan. I think he's talking to Mutombo. And he hits.
All right, moving right along. Stage number four. Folks, I'm going to share something with you. My biggest downfall as a human being is that I never ask for help. I'm terrible at it. I'm so stubborn and bullheaded that I think I can do everything myself. Well, guess what, folks? You can't. Anytime I've reached success in my life, it's been through mentorship, right? Having somebody help me, reaching out for help. So stage number four is to unify. Unification. Build a team. Here's five essential team members you must have that I think every fit pro should have. Number one, a financial advisor, a fiduciary expert that understands money and P&Ls. If you don't have a financial advisor, it is going to be hard for you to actualize your human potential. Second person you need in your life is legal representation. Hopefully it's not criminal defense legal representation, but you need a contract attorney. For me, I've got a great contract attorney, and for my line of work, I've got a patent attorney also. These guys are on speed dial, so anytime an issue comes up with a contract or a patent, I've got these folks that I can refer to. The third person, and this could be multiple people, by the way, is a mentor, right? I've had mentors left and right, and these are people that I actually do listen to. I've had a mentor in my Taekwondo, Master Dale Burkhart. He took me to a pretty high level in martial arts. I've had a mentor in strength and conditioning, Jim Beardmore, the best man at my wedding. Guys off the wall, but he taught me about strength and conditioning at the fundamental roots of it, and that's what kind of catapulted my career in the SNC world. In business, one of my clients, longtime client, Sidney Kimmel, founder of Jones Apparel of New York. At one time, he was a Forbes 500 guy, and he taught me more about business and just listening to how he interacted on the phone and how he built his team up and his leadership capabilities and his knowledge about clothing and manufacturing. Man, did that ooze off and penetrate into my soul. And I used him. I leaned on these folks when I needed them for mentorship. How about somebody that has computer skills? By the way, my computer died. This was about 3 months ago. People literally thought that my dog had been hit by a car. That's how I was walking around, like so downtrodden and despondent and dejected. I just couldn't function without my computer. Man, would it be nice to have a computer specialist on speed dial. I finally got somebody in Aspen that makes house calls. Her name's Katrina. If you're in Aspen, you gotta call Katrina. And she works on Macs and she is brilliant. So have somebody on speed dial that you can call and help with computer needs. And then finally, this may or may not be applicable depending on what you do, but having some kind of videographer or still photographer. Maybe you're creating a pitch deck and you need lifestyle images or product images or gym images. Maybe you're shooting a lot of content, digital content, marketing content, social media content. You need a videographer. And a lot of times these folks can do trade outs. So you don't have to necessarily pay for everybody because this gets expensive. But man, if you look at Todd Durkin's stuff on social media, now occasionally he has a selfie, you know, post or something where he's holding the phone himself. But it's 9 times out of 10, it's high level quality production stuff. And he's got a videographer on staff that he uses for his content. That's why he's got a tremendous social media following, and that's why it's the Todd Durkin Impact Summit and not the Pete Holman Impact Summit. I love you, Todd. So unification. Folks, I can't believe we are here. It is the time to reveal the fifth stage of the Holman hierarchy of Fit Pro self-actualization. What's it gonna be? Amplify. That's a terrible eye, by the way. What am I doing there? Amplify. Amplification. This is where you scream from the mountaintops. This is who I am. This is what I'm doing. It's time to execute on your vision, on your mission statement. I'm doing this right now. I've got a product. I've had a lot of cool products, and I've had some pretty good success with my products. But this product, folks, I'm so excited about this. This is an in-home glute training machine that you can buy as a consumer that trains your glutes in multiple planes of motion. Glutes are hot right now. The hip thrust is hot. I'm very excited about this product. I've got a non-provisional patent. Cost me tons of time and energy and finances. I've created 3 prototypes to prove the model and the concept. My 3rd prototype came straight out of Asia. It is fantastic. I'm clicking on all cylinders. I've got content ready to go. And now the tires need to hit the pavement. I need money. I need seed capital. I've got to launch this project either on my own or get a licensor. And I've been reaching out to folks. And I'm telling you, I don't know what's going on. Don't they know who I am? Don't they know my track record? I'm not getting the money that I want. I'm not getting the licensors that I want. I'm hitting a roadblock. I'm hitting adversity. And I'm frustrated. I'm downtrodden. I'm bummed out. I'm tired. I'm going through all this stuff in my personal life. Like, can't I get a break? And some days I just shrug my shoulders and think, maybe it's not to be, you know? And then the athlete comes out of me. That dogged perseverance, that grit, that like almost welcoming adversity, you know? Bring it on. I got this. I want to share a story with you. This is honestly one of the most remarkable sports stories I've ever witnessed. And it involves an Olympic athlete, tremendous adversity, and self-actualization. Dan Jansen was the youngest of 9 children and grew up in Wisconsin, which is actually where both my parents are from. He was introduced to speed skating by his big sister, Jane, and the family quickly realized he was a prodigal son. He made his first Olympics in Sarajevo at the age of 19 and placed 4th in the 500 meters, his best event, and 14th in the 1,000 meter. Jansen went into the 88 Olympics in Calgary and was a hands-down favorite for winning gold in both the 500 and 1,000 meter events. However, his sister, who was losing a battle with leukemia, died literally hours before he took the ice. He spoke with her briefly before her passing and said he was going to win the gold for her. Unfortunately, Jansen fell on his first corner of his 500 meters and was out of the race, but he had one more chance in the 1,000 meter race days later. Tragically, he fell again, once again leaving the Olympics without a podium. Jansen, still a dominant skater and gold medal favorite, returned to the Albertville Olympics in 1992 and missed the podium in the 500 meter by 0.2 of a second. Can you imagine that? Ugh. And then completely fell apart in the 1,000 meter, placing 26th. In the lead up to the Lillehammer Olympics in 1994, Jansen was once again a dominant skater, winning the Gold Cup that year and was flying high after having his first child, Jane, named after his sister who had passed away. However, the question loomed, could he ever win the big race? With his family in the crowd and the whole world watching what would be his last Olympic Games, Jansen bobbled in his best event, the 500 meter, and finished 8th. Jansen had one last attempt to make the podium in his worst event, the 1,000 meters. If he didn't win, his entire career would be marred with failure, disappointment, and heartbreak. As he approached the starting position, he recalled that something was wrong with his skates. They weren't gripping the ice, and his legs felt wobbly and unsolid and heavy. He thought to himself, well, at least in a minute and a half, the nightmare will be over. Regardless of how he felt, I knew something that Dan Jansen didn't know at the time. You see, he had climbed the Holman hierarchy of self-actualization. He had purified himself of all the toxins and worked through the loss of his sister. He had qualified his mission, which was to be on the podium in the Olympics and inspire the world to overcome adversity. He had calcified his body and mind by putting in 10,000 plus hours on the ice. He had unified by building a tremendous team and now even had young Jane rooting him on. The only thing he had left to do was to amplify his message and turn his dream into a reality. And his last chance to ever compete on speed skates, when the lights were shining their brightest, and when everyone in the world was fearing the worst. Not only did Dan Jansen win his first ever gold medal, he set a new world record. Folks, if that doesn't get you fired up and inspired, I can't help you. Listen, you've got all the tools. Now it's time to execute. Go out, purify, exercise the demons. Qualify, who are you? What are you about? Write down your mission statement. Calcify, practice, 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 unify, build that team around you, and no matter what, you climb to the top of the mountain, you plant your feet firmly in the soil, and you yell at the top of your lungs, I am here to actualize my God-given human potential. Ha! Folks, listen, I appreciate you, I respect you, and most importantly, I believe in you. Until next time, Pete Holman signing off. Get after it, everybody.